So I want to reflect back again on what the why of innovation. We discussed last week, why are we talking about innovation? As a topic, as a course of study in a school like this, Federal University of Petroleum Resources, Department of Vocational and Entrepreneurship Studies. Why are we talking about innovation? Yeah, who want to give me just a few? Why do we need to talk about innovation, think about innovation?
Invention to sustainable development. You say the reason why we all need to learn about innovation is that in every human being, it's either you create or you start. There's no mountain, and we still learn that. In the world, there's only 70% of people who are business entrepreneurs, ordinary people, just 20 business and just 10 innovative. That in every aspect of our life, we need to have this idea, you know, creative in all that you want to do or you are doing.
Thank you so much. That in life, there's a principle that summarized the whole thing. That it is either you create or you start. That is the first law that God gave to man, right from the Garden of Eden. Because after creating man, the first assignment was he landed man in the garden to reward it, to recreate it. And that principle is the principle that guides man till today. So the few persons, as I said this last week, we have 70% of people 70% who are ordinary. 20% are business or entrepreneurs. Business or entrepreneurs. While just 10% are innovators. And we said that is the bane of the African continent. Despite all the resources in Africa, for instance, we have the landmass, we have the solar sun everywhere, but Africa is still in darkness. Africa has the largest water body, rivers, but no water to drink. Can you just imagine that? The mineral resources, pebbles, petroleum, and other precious minerals, the largest deposit in the world, are in Africa. But still, Africa is the poorest continent in the world. Why? Because of what? Lack of innovation. Lack of innovation. We lack the innovative approach to harness the resources we have. And with this said that the only way to have a sustainable business and continue to be in business is innovation. You know why? Because what you are trying to do, there are so many weathers outside there. There are so many fashion designers, tailors outside there. There are many, so many ICT people outside there. The only thing that will make your own unique and keep you in business, generating customer year in and year out, is innovation. When you add a dimension that have never been seen, what has never been done in that line of business, you keep getting customer. That is the reason why we are thinking of, we are talking about innovation. And as I said, innovation is the key. Listen to this statement by the man Dr. Edward G. Bono. There is no doubt that innovation is the most important human resources of all. Do you hear that? That innovation is the most important human resources of all you can think about. Without innovation, there will be no progress. And we will be forever repeating the same pattern. If innovation is the most important of human resources, I begin to wonder, why is innovation not taught in primary school? Why is innovation as subject not taught in secondary school? And I told you last week, this is the first time This university is introducing this course, innovation. You are the first set of students benefiting from this. Are you not privileged?
Yes, sir.
I say, are you not privileged?
Yes, sir.
If innovation is so important, the most important human resources that we need to survive, to create, and sustain the system, sustain your business, and support me. So you are very, very privileged to be part of this lecture. Listen again, Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "He who would be a man must therefore be a nonconformist. She that would be a woman. He who would be a man must be a nonconformist." Do you understand that? Nonconformist is a big word. Who can break it down? Yes, can you tell something?
Visual way of life, visual mobility around. Don't conform to something. You need not to bend towards that direction.
That's why I talk to that.
Somebody that will not follow the visual way of doing things.
Two of you are right. If you want to be a businessman, businesswoman among the others, there are others, millions of them. If you want to be separate, unique, you see, you must be a non-conformist. You must not follow the usual way of doing it. Create something unique. Let them know you. To offer something that people in the environment cannot offer. Let them know you to be the one that is doing it in an extraordinary, different way. That is innovation. And that is what we need if we must progress as individual, as group, as family, as community, as nation. We cannot do without innovation. So today we will try to go a little further and to ask ourselves, what is innovation and who is an innovator? That's the topic of this question. What is and who? Innovation, if we must understand it before we can really get to the to know how we can become one, is the process of translating idea or invention into a product or services that create value for which customer will pay for. Write it down. Innovation. Yeah, some of you don't know how to read. We are coming to, you know, I mentioned something last week, that the key to innovation is the PFC, the prefrontal cortex, the part of your brain that need to be exercised, need to be used. Until you discover and use it, I said again, the PFC will remain the level of an animal. That's why you see people crowd, going to school, going to churches, going to program, they remain the same level. Because they have not discovered that center that's in the human brain. It's a different lecture, we'll come to that. But what I try to say is that through repetition, listening again and again, reading again and again, you master the subject. And if you master this art of innovation, you will be a master of all. Do you hear what I said?
Yes.
If you master the subject of innovation, you will be a master of all. So innovation, I said again, is the process of translating an idea. You have an idea. How many of you have an idea? Wow. You have a creative idea. Huh? That idea needs to be translated into a product or a service that adds value to people's life, to the society. Then people are willing to pay. That is your innovation. That is the process. Hello? Does somebody understand what I'm saying? It's just 1% past duration. But the success is 99% past duration. You want to be Prince of that country. You want to be a fashion designer, an ICT expert. You want to be a welder. You want to be a catering specialist, a caterer. You want to be a specialist in leather work. It's good. It's just 1% inspiration. But for it to come to pass, you will need 99% what? Aspiration. So the process of translating that idea into a product or service that is useful to human beings and they are willing to pay for it is simply to term innovation. As you can see here, there is a remarkable difference between creative idea and innovation. Can you see the difference?
Yes, sir.
Eh? Somebody that's having an idea and somebody that's an innovator. Please report. Your idea is passive. Listen to me. Your idea is passive until something is added to it that makes it what? An innovation. Until you take it, create it, form it, process the idea, add value to it, and take it to market. And people say, wow, we are ready to pay for this thing that you have brought. It becomes what? An innovation. So, innovation, the process, in one of the lectures, we will dwell more, analyze more, the process of creating a product from ideas. And we'll show you practically how I have done it, and many others have done it. By special grace of God, I have over 7 innovations. 7 different innovations. I will show you how we did it and how you can do it also. For an idea to be called an innovation, it must have economic value. Economic what?
Value.
Economic value means it must attract money. So innovation is the key to money. When you have an innovation, you're automatically in money. Is somebody understanding?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Do you need money?
Yes, sir.
I'm not need money.
Yes,
sir. That is the answer. Yeah, this is my sister. I don't need money. I said, I'm not need money. So the quickest way to get money is innovation. For instance, Jeff Bezos, the owner of Amazon, is the richest man in the world. What made him to be richest? Innovated on e-commerce, how to sell things online, move things all over the world, in the platform. E-commerce has become the richest man in the whole world. Bill Gates innovated on software, computer system, and is the richest, one of the richest person in the world. Mark Zuckerberg, the owner of what? Facebook, innovated on how to make friends, social media. So the best way to have money is not just, it's just to be innovative. If you can't be innovative with your idea, you can make any amount of money you want to make. So that is the secret. So if we must cure the malady, the decadence, the backwardness, the underdevelopment in the society, especially in Africa. When we talk about Africa, we are talking about ourselves, your family. Every one of us, we are here, we come from a family. We can smell, we can feel the level of poverty, hunger, backwardness. Do we want, do we desire to cure it?
Yeah.
I said, do we desire to cure it?
Yes, sir.
All we need is how we can use information, imagination, and initiative to transmit and translate our ideas into innovation. If we can do it, if we can master that art of innovation, then we are off from the level of poverty and suffering. So you can become a master of innovation. And I said, in the world we have only 10% of people that are innovators. Only 10% of people. How many of you want to be among innovators? How many of you want to be among innovators? They can be in the same street. For sure, whether here, the other one here. I was in a mechanic village sometime in Joss, back in the area of Joss. And I went to meet a mechanic. He was sitting down in his workshop with his hand, just like this, my sister. With his hand on the door. Why other mechanics are busy fixing motor? I looked to him. Is there any problem? He said, well, say you can see all my mates, they work. Work comes to them. And they are busy doing fixing motor, fixing engine, fixing it. But I will come here, I will sit down from morning to evening. And as a matter of fact, with my workshop here, my family and I were starving. The man opened his mouth and opened up to me. I sat him down for some few minutes and I told him what he ought to do, how he needs to add value, devise ways of attending to customer, add new techniques to his workshop, and by the grace of God, he can succeed. After I discussed with him, I left. I went back, I think about 3 weeks later. The man saw me coming. He was running towards me, running. He said, come, the situation has changed. I've gone to market since you left me more than 2 times now. My products, my customers, everything is coming. That is the magic of innovation. So, two passion or tailor people can be on the same line. One can be attracting customers, the other one is not there. The difference that will make you map it out to enjoy the surplus is innovation. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes.
So then, who are the innovators? The innovators are those who see with different eyes. They see what?
With different eyes.
You look at the challenges of the society. Instead of it discouraging, they say, what can I offer? What can I do to change the situation? So they see with different eyes. That is one characteristic of innovators. Instead of seeing problems and challenges, they see solutions, they see new solutions. Innovator. Number two, innovators are those that think differently than the ordinary person. They are filled with creative, inspiring thoughts. They think differently. Innovators. They are walking in the streets, they see something, they will ask, why is this thing so? What can I do to change it? What else can I do to add value to this? They are always inquisitive. So they think differently from ordinary people. Innovators. Number three, innovators, they act and do things differently from others. What did I say? They are game changers. They are disruptors. They don't follow the normal way people, ordinary people are doing it. Because Albert Einstein said, it's madness for you to follow every way, the way they have been doing it, and they have been doing it every day, every now, and you are expecting a different result. It's what?
Madness.
So they do things differently. Creating new systems from what the normal pattern. That's what innovation is about. They hear and listen with positive insights. They hear and listen with what? Positive insight. When they listen to news, they are analyzing that news. What can I get from the news? For instance, let me break this down for you. In 2012, I was listening to the session of the World Health Organization. There was a meeting of the World Health Organization in Geneva. and they were deliberating on the high cost of health care that is the cause of poverty in the world. Do you get that? That the amount of money people are spending on health care is one of the causes of poverty in the world. That was 2012. That meeting was being held in Geneva, but I was in my house. I was listening to the session. After the talks, I asked myself, if healthcare is costing so much and people are getting poorer, what can I do to change the narrative? And I discovered that the cost of why the cost, why people are sick, spend so much on medicine, on healthcare is acidity. What did I say?
Acidity.
Acidity in the food we eat, acidity in the water we use, acidity in the environment, the air, just like Niger Delta here, the air is polluted. As we are breathing it, it's acidic. Acidity in the cream, some of the chemicals, the drugs we use, so the body is full of acid. And that is the greatest cause of diseases. And I ask myself, as a pharmacologist, what can I do to solve this problem? I went into research. How we can have alkaline water that can help the human body to remove the acidity and the body can be free from sickness without taking drugs. Because the law of medicine from my books, from my medical books, states that when the human body is alkaline, not one disease, not one, even cancer can survive. But when the human body is acidic, the disease survives. So all this inflation, diabetes, hypertension, stroke, and all that, they are caused by acidity. So after listening to the World Health, I went into research. I'm told,
I'm just talking to you about innovation works.
Just solve problems. I told you this class is very practical. This is ordinary water we drink. They are called pure water, bottled water, they are all acidic. I did some tests, and but most 80-90% of them are acidic. People are obese because of acidity. People are sick because of acidity. You take drugs, they don't work because the acidity block the receptors from alkaline. And this solution has helped so many people with incurable sicknesses, incurable diseases. It reduces stress. In fact, last week I was having eye problem. Instead of going to buy eye ointment, I diluted my alkaline water, put it, and I'm okay. So what am I trying to say? There was a news item that health challenges is causing poverty because of the high cost of medication. And the cause of this is acidity. So I have decided to work on that news information. And behold, this is the outcome. This alkaline water produces a lesser dose, I mean, concentration. This is a high concentration. This is ordinary water we take. If I bring my test and I test this theory, you will see the difference. That is clear. Water, but of different class. This is innovation. Innovation. Based on what I heard, I swear I told you, innovators, they hear and think differently. So, and it has solved the problem of healthcare for many. And generates money for me. Every day I'm in my house, somebody will knock. I need alkaline water. Because of what is it doing. Since 2013, we started using it in my house without buying drugs, without going to hospital. I wake up in the morning, take a cup of it. The night I'm sleeping, take a cup of it. I'm okay because it removes the acid, which is the acid in the human body, is the substrate where bacteria, fungi, viruses survive. And this removes it. This is an example of how innovators work. Is somebody clear? Get in the class. Because I told you the class must make it practical. So that you understand what we are talking. Just theory, noise is not enough. So innovators, they work, they think, they reason, and they act differently from others. There are types and classes of innovations and innovators. First of all, we have the incremental innovators. They bring something on gradual process, increments, small, bit by bit. They bring changes, bit by bit. We call it then incremental what? Innovators. Increment. Incremental. Don't worry about the spelling. When you get the hand out, you get it. Okay? Then we have the disruptive innovators. What did I say?
Disrupt.
To disorganize. To follow they bring sudden change. Disruptive innovators. Entirely different approach. They bring a entirely different approach. This is the way people have been doing it, but when the disruptive innovators enter the same pattern, they bring something different way of doing it. They call them disruptive. That's why times innovators are sometimes referred to as disruptors. Not destroyers. Not destroy. They disrupt. They disrupt the system. So we have also architectural innovators. Those are architectural. They specialize in making designs on the process, designing. We call them architectural innovators. I said number one, we have incremental, disruptive, architectural, and the number four, the radical innovators. The radical, what did I say?
Radical
innovators. People said it cannot work. But they believe it can work. For instance, Henry Ford, who created the vehicle we are using? Henry Ford is the inventor of the vehicle. He has in mind, thinking his mind to invent what he called the new model, the Ford model. And he told his engineer, well, I have this mind that we should have a model of a car, this new. He described it. And the engineers, he said, go to the lab and design it. They went to the lab, they came back to Henry Ford, said, sir, it cannot be done. The design cannot be done. That model cannot be done. So, you know what he told them? Say, go and work. They came back the second time. After much trial, some months of trial, they came back to Mr. Ford. Say, Mr. Ford, it can never be done. You know what he told them again? Go and work. For the third time, they came back again. Say, Mr. Ford, we have tried everything possible to design that model. It is not possible. Henry Ford looked at them, said, go and walk. But the first time they came back, they came with a solution. The radical innovators. You don't believe me, it cannot be done. They bring very sudden changes now and then. So you can decide to fit in any of this area. Also, we have the kind of innovators and innovations. We have those who specialize in product innovation. They bring out a totally new product that is not already existing. New product entirely. We call the product what? Innovators. They innovate on new products. We also have the process innovators and process innovations. Those that work on the process, the approach of how something is done, how we can do it faster, quicker. We call them process innovators. For instance, a good example is the digital technology. Is somebody understanding me?
Yes, sir.
The digital technology. In advanced country, they don't carry money in their pocket. Eh? Everything is paid for through smart card. That is digital technology. And money is going to one central account. So that limits the rate of corruption. Because the money is not going to any person's account. Everything is digitalized. The railway system works 24 hours. The light system works 24 hours, digitalized. So that is the value of innovation, process innovation. For instance, this lecture, as we are here right now, can be transmitted all over the world. You know that?
Yes, sir.
You know that?
Yes, sir.
This video, the recording, can be transmitted to all over the world, and people all over the world can see this lecture, listen to it, learn what we are talking. At the same time, but in those days, for you to send a letter, you know how much, how many hours, how many days, how many weeks, how many months it will take. But now with a press of a button, bam, it's gone. Eh? That is the beauty, the value of innovation. Apart from the product innovators, the process innovators, we also have the business model innovators. They bring about new business models, new business concepts. Think and then think about new business concepts. Today we have so much waste in Africa. Look, all these glasses you see, our heads. They can bring new business concepts. So that we don't know how to innovate on them, package it. The opportunity is so large in Africa. In fact, some white people, most from them struggle to come to Africa. They struggle to come to Africa because they know that the opportunity, the resources are there. The people don't know how to use them. So we need to wake up to the art of innovation. Innovative thinking, strategic thinking. Use our PFC to bring about new products, new design, new processes. And above all, we have a combination of the three. We call them super innovators. What did I say?
Super innovators.
Yes. They can bring products, new products. They can bring new process. They can bring new business models. So they combine all the characteristics of innovators, super innovators. Today, I'm being called a principal innovator, which means I'm a super innovator. As I said, I have a number of innovations. I went to, for instance, fish farming, 2009, and I failed. You know why I failed?
No.
You know why I failed?
No.
The cost of feeding fishes by buying the imported feed fish, you cannot get profit. It's impossible. The feeding takes over 70 to 80%. So I failed. After failing, you know what I did? I went.
How come about this?
This one. I said it's floating fish feed for feeding fish. For fish farmer, those who want to make profit in fish farmer, they use it to feed the fish and it floats, the fish will feed it. Okay? So it makes them, this one makes them get profit. Before now, they don't get profit because the cost of buying it from the foreign one is very high. So I decided, through inspiration from God, use waste combined with the ingredient to formulate it, to help. How I did it, I should give you the formula. What is all my secrets? I'm going to tell you later. Eh? Yes, madam, let's hear it.
My question is about the alkaline water. How can we use it in our various homes? How can we get it? How can we use it?
Well, as I said, for instance, if you have the concentrated one like this, you put it in there. 2 liters for this one. But if you have a concentrated one, you put it for 4 liters. Take it one morning and cup one morning. You will see it washing your system and like, you know. So, you made it. It's not far away. This year.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes.
Sir,
yes.
Does it not have any side effects?
Well, normally too much of everything is bad.
Yes.
There is a state we call alkalinosis. Alkalinosis is when your body becomes too alkaline. It makes you weak and a lot of complications. But in Africa, you cannot get there. Gary, acidity. Rice, acidity. Everything we eat is acidic. Water is acidic. So we can't get to that. So by using it liberally to keep yourself, you enjoy your health. Okay? Yes.
If you want to, the one at the center now, let's say you want to have this very hard one. Like, how many percent do you need to add?
I said you can add potential water to 2 liters of water. So if you have a water, you add it to 4 liters of water, how many water do you need to drink?
I don't know how far it is, but a pharmacist told me that too much, that is when you reduce the acid, in your body to zero level, that you find it difficult.
Even to walk.
Yes, the food you eat will not be able to
that. Of course, that's what I said before.
So by taking the alkaline water, won't we reduce?
Hello, I said because of we complicate what we drink. Okay, curry, sash, yam, rice, or even the water. Some of those pure water. Give me pure water and drink. It's acid. So there's no way we can go without that. No. Oh, we do this one. We get it. Balance it up. Balance it up. Keep the body minimum alkaline. Yes. Welcome.
Sir, according to the menu intervention foundation system, is it somebody that my product or I myself must have a blog or must have a website before I can participate? Because I myself have been trying to participate in the new foundation without having difficulties in that. So I really want to know.
Okay. Yeah. We will guide you, as I said. So before some of you finish your course, we will guide you how to apply and succeed. Okay? To have a blog is ABC, simple as ABC. Our computer, the graphic department, they can do it for you. With ABC. Okay, then you put samples of your product. Tell them what you are doing. Because when you are applying and you put your blog there or your site there, it gives you credibility. Okay? Last night I submitted this idea, I submitted it to United Nations. They are looking for innovative ideas like this now that can create a job for the people of the world to solve the problem of underdevelopment, hunger, poverty, and they requested for this idea. Okay? For them to see it, I put my details, my blog, the product, the how everything is done, and the samples inside the blog. So they will not need to see me, but by just clicking on the blog, they will know that this thing is real. Okay? So that is why it's necessary for you to have it. So we are going to guide you how you can prepare yourself. So by next year, January, before the form will be out, you are already prepared. Many of you here will benefit from the 20 years in the family.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Is there any other question?
You included everything. You need it producing that float fish inside your blog. Yes, me, I'm not really. I want to be convinced that everything that has to do with the fish is inside the blog. Is it true?
I can't get you. That
everything, yes, that is in the process, you use it producing this float fish, is inside the blog.
Oh no, I can't tell you the process. I can only tell you the progress. Hello? Hello? You know the blog, you can see the sound. You can see the problem. Details of how and it is. That's secret.
That's your secret.
Yes. I'm not going to take Coca-Cola. Coke. Have you ever seen Coke formula on the bottle?
No.
Somebody went to a chemist and saw an edible substance and bought it. he went home and missed something with it. And that's what we are doing. We don't tell any human being the form. You can only buy it and drink. If you are walking the same, you don't get to replace the music. Okay? So it will be with you. You can only show people within the days. That is how innovation works. Okay? There's what we call pitted right. Peter Drake. Peter Drake. Based on this and other products are invented. Okay? So once you have that Peter Drake, even though somebody discovered a secret and used it, you can sue the person. Because it's your own right. In Nigeria as a whole, what I use to produce this, if any person uses it, I can sue the person.
T-shirt.
So that is how it works. Any other question?
Tell me that you can't drink it alone.
Yes. So tell me that you cannot drink it alone. If somebody is very sick, you can take it wrong.
Okay. Wait, only if person is sick.
Huh?
Wait, only somebody.
But if you want to maintain your body system, it's a matter of blood diluting it and taking it to your body.
Like, how many quantity? People that is on drugs and is very sick, can this
be
taken?
Hello. It destroys drugs. Because drugs is acidic. So when you want to take drugs, you use ordinary water. And you wait for 1 hour, then you can take your alcohol.
You can see doctor
later. Be prepared this to become a solution provider, an innovator that will bring innovation to Nigeria, Africa, and the world. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.